with the lens, and I trust you can hear me. Those things are pure malcontent, the residue of lives unfulfilled.
Thank you. cannot stop us!
Follow the flow of ether. It will guide you. Is too dense. Oh, I'm losing you.
You cannot stop us! stop us!
I will not hold back!
In this folly no longer.
You cannot stop us.
The stage is set. futures. Delusions and lies! My very essence begins to wane. Sweet, sweet agony.
Leave this to her.
Come to deal the coup de grace. Good. Watching you struggle against the inevitable is bad comedy. Erase me from existence, soul and all. How did you know that name? Then it was you. In Elpis. With them it sucked. The final pieces fall into place. In my halcyon days, as the mortal Ammon, I was haunted by a dream. Night after night, the faceless multitude, the voiceless cries. Shards of shattered memories. But slowly, the fog began to clear. This was Elpis. And I was Hermes. Recurring though it was, I paid this dream little heed. It was only when I was granted the seat and memories of Fandaniel, that I knew these visions to be true. They were the memories of Hermes that he himself erased using the power of Kairos. Or so he thought, in his attempt to burn away the events of that fateful day. He succeeded only in searing them more deeply into his soul. My soul. Death failed to expunge them. No matter how many times it came. Rebirth after rebirth, from one Fandaniel to the next. I wonder, is Emmet Selk adrift somewhere in this ethereal sea? In defeat, finally remembering your time together in Elpis. How it must gall him
to be entrusted with knowledge of the final days, only to be rendered powerless to act upon it. So many lifetimes dedicated to restoring his beloved Amaroth in blissful ignorance. Oh, folly. But make no mistake. My life as Hermes is not the reason I invited the world's end. I have lived. I have struggled. I have dredged the very depths of despair. And in the detritus of existence, I found the truth. I served a great ruler, powerful beyond measure. The world, his dominion. Yet even he and his vast empire were destined to fall, to become one with oblivion. At the end of life's journey lies only death. So I ask you, why live at all? We betray, we torment, we murder. We are wicked, spiteful creatures, without exception. If life is so sacred, so precious, why fill it with such misery? Man wallows in a hell of his own making without purpose or meaning. To live is to suffer, and I would end that suffering by my own hand. It matters not if it flies in the face of all believed right and just. Death is the only solution! That is my truth, my answer to the question, and yet, even as the words pass my lips, I am filled with doubt as my search reached its end. Was this the only way? After all these years, is this the answer I was hoping for?
The lamentations of the damned. How it vexes me to see your conviction falter at the last. Fandaniel, still clinging to existence, I see. You, who champion death so fervently, unwilling to accept your own, refusing to be purified and swept into the sea of souls, as do I. We prisoners to men, watching as the world turns. Though unlike me, you will be spared the ignominy of having your corpse made a puppet, dancing to another's tune.
Is that Arcee?
How very astute. But let me be clear, I have not come to consort with the likes of you. Nor have I come to bemoan the state of the world following my untimely demise. In fact, I delight in mankind's downfall and the anguish it brings the savior of the savages. If I played some small part in the chaos, all the better. Not that I was in any position to resist. But to be made accomplice to the betrayal of Lord Zenos, I would die 1,000 deaths to exact my vengeance. Now you are at my mercy. I shall drag us both into oblivion, and you will never see the fulfillment of your magnum opus. Even should you be reborn, your desperate search for answers must start again.
And what might that be? My wish is all but granted. To die and take you all with me.
Don't try to follow me. I had more of you people than I could stomach in life. Never mind in death.
Likewise, I pray we do not meet again.
You had better hope not.
Come. Hydaelyn is waiting.
Brave travelers, I welcome you. I see. Thou didst journey unto Elpis. And now, the rivers of time converge. I know why you have come. Yet I would hear you speak your reasons all the same.
You created the moon to deliver mankind from the final days. But is that really how it has to end? We do not wish to abandon this world. We want to protect the source and all of its shards.
To flee is but one of two paths. The other leadeth to Meteon, far beyond the stars, where she doth chant creation's requiem. Her domain is formed of dynamis. Pure. Absolute. Where emotion and memory govern all, ether will avail you naught. Meteon hath gathered the pain and despair of countless stars, and to go unprepared is to go unto your doom.
We'll beat her. We'll win. I swear it. Is what I might have said once. After everything I've seen, all the times I've succumbed to my own anger and fear, I can no longer pretend that courage and faith will be enough. But are we truly so powerless that our only choice is to flee?
Far from it, my child. Long ago, the inhabitants of myriad stars, many more prosperous than Atheris, sought to free their worlds from life's woes. Sorrow and anger, conflict and hostility, despair, and even death itself. But as Meteon reported, every attempt ended in failure. Darkness abideth within every living being, and can never be cast out. Neither reason nor faith can challenge this immutable truth. To live is to suffer. And in suffering, find strength and purpose. And hope. As you have done so many times before. Thou dost pursue an impossible dream, yet knowing this, you pursue it nevertheless. And thou hast learned to depend on others as they do thee. Thy yearning for the power to save the powerless hath ever driven thee to greater heights. Thou hast grown strong. Though those closest to thee no longer walketh by thy side, their love remaineth thy guiding light. For duty's sake, thou hast been bound by truths unutterable time and time again. Yet thy heart hath never wavered, as thy companions will attest. In thy pursuit of mysteries great, all thou believest is brought into question. Undaunted, thy thirst for knowledge remaineth unquenched. The fires of hatred that once burned in thy heart burneth no more. From their ashes doth spring the light of love, warm and pure. As witness to black calamity, thou despaired at man's helplessness. Resolved, thou didst unite a distant world on the brink of collapse. And thou, my champion, when all did seem lost, thou never abandoned hope. For every trial and every foe that did bar thy way, thou hast proven equal to the challenge, drawing courage from the many bonds forged on thy journey. You have all known despair, and though the end approacheth, you walk on, heads held high. Therein lieth your power. The strength to silence the song of oblivion.
Then there is a means to confront her.
Yes, if you should prove yourselves worthy. Hark! Nigh impossible is it to send mortals to the edge of the universe. Should you fail, there will be no second chance. As the will of the star, I ask of you this. Do you possess the fortitude to stand firm when all around you doth crumble? Do you possess the faith to vanquish despair itself? Should you lack the strength to best a supreme deity, I cannot allow you to make the journey. You must leave this star and never return. Prepare yourselves.
Prove ourselves worthy. Sounds straightforward enough.
Aye. No room for confusion there. In any case, we've come too far to back down now.
I am of the same mind. What power I have, I shall bring to bear.
The three of you seem to be forgetting who we're up against. It's not every day we battle a divine being of untold power. Well, not quite every day. Do try not to get underfoot. Needless to say, there'll be no margin for error.
Let us hold nothing back. For the people of this world and those beyond the rift.
Alas, the question I posed to thee in Elpis hath remained unanswered these long years. I would hear thy response, warrior of light, shouldst thou emerge victorious.